Amen.
Power of the sea.
break every chain. Whatever it is that they're going through, whether it be, you know, financial, mental health, through whatever it is that they're going through, that God whispers in their ear, let go and let me. I say, I need this faith the size of a mustard seed. Please continue to pray for our state and our world. And then welcome back, Miss Flo. With that being said, I'll hand you over to our pastor, Reverend Carl Snowden Sr.
Missing, sick, on vacation or whatever, but we need to pray for one another. We need to let each other know that we care and we want to know what's happening and what's going on. So from time to time, I make calls to when people are missing in action. Maybe I need to make calls when they're in action.
See,
God is good.
Amen.
God is good. He's able to break every chain.
Yes, he
He's
is.
Able to let us know how good he is.
Yes.
See, I tell people, Pastor, I'm not feeling well. I have a lot of problems and things. This is what church is for.
Amen.
To bring your problems to the Lord.
Yes.
This is the house of the Lord. Ooh. You see, in the Old Testament, once a year, they could only go and bring their problems up, their wrongdoing to the Lord. But we have every Sunday, even through the week, that we can do and have God to help relieve us of our situation. We ask for, could you pray for me on the phone? Well, what's wrong with you coming into the church to be praying for? You know, we can do what we want to do, but when it comes to the Lord, we got to be almost dead and murdered before we want to really try to get to church.
Yeah.
But see, when you come to church, you should leave here better than what you left.
Amen.
So if you're sick, you're going to leave here better than what you left.
Thank you.
Because you bring it to the Lord.
Yeah.
If you got less money, if you pray, he going to help you get more money.
Yeah.
If you have a jobless or things are going on, if you bring it to the Lord in sincerity, God will bless. We have more than one excuse for not getting here, but when things get bad, we have a lot of excuses for getting here. But we better start checking ourselves.
Yeah.
Checking ourselves and not be about ourselves, but it's about God's business that we're here for. May God bless you. And Sister Flo, we had to go into the lost and found department. It's good to see you. It's good to see each and every one that's here today that want to let the Lord know that how you know how he loved, how he brought you through whatever you went through or whatever you're going through.
Yes, yes.
He's the answer. He's the answer. And he tells you to bring it to him.
Yes.
Bring it to him and he'll make a difference.
Thank you.
You don't depend on any and everybody. Come to the Lord. Come to his house.
Yeah.
House of worship.
Yes.
House of praise.
Yes.
House of blessing. And see what he can do. And quit standing at home watching the football game, or you can watch baseball or basketball or watch TV. But come to the Lord.
Yes.
Come to his house. And get his action feeling and spirit. And he'll bless you. He'll make a difference. Bow your head for prayer. Oh, Father God, as we come at this time with thanksgiving in our hearts and our minds, Father. We thank you for last night as we slept in slumber,
yes,
Father.
Thank you,
God. We thank you for this new day, our opportunity to praise you, to learn more about you, Father. We ask you to touch hearts and minds. Let your Holy Spirit run all through this church rampant and just helping changing and let people know by faith. Unseen things can be coming to maturity, coming to seeing things if you have belief, if you have a faith, if you're disciplined, if you come and talk to the Lord. Bring your problem to the altar and ask the Lord to change them. Their faith. He's got open heart for you. He's ready for you. All he wants you to do is come to him and talk to him.
Yeah.
so you can show people what he can do and will do, how he can change the world, he can change the problem, he can change the situation, not just yours, all. Father, we ask you to bless all churches that opened this morning. We ask you to bless all Christians that you have opened their eyes this morning to you, Father, to worship you. We ask to bless those that don't know you to change from their wicked ways, that you may heal their land and heal their hearts and minds, Father. Give us a new awakening of what you can do and will do, Father. We need you now. We need you forever, Father. We ask you these things and all things. Yes. In the Son's name, Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Oh, Father God, as we come, we lift this offering up to you, that it be used for lifting up your kingdom and building and helping of those that we can help, Father. We need help, and we ask you to help us use what we give, and let us be able to give freely and not grudgingly, and knowing that it's not ours, no way. We just borrowing from you anyway. So we just giving you back what you've given us, Father. And we thank you, because if we die, we can't take it with us. So if what we give now makes a difference, it makes a difference in our hearts, our minds, our finances, and everything. If we're able to give and give grudgingly, give freely, and just thank you for what you have given us, and thank you what you will give us if we learn to get on the same page with you, Father. We ask you these things in all things. In Son's name, Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. In the hands of the choir and Urshan.
Amen. The Holy Spirit is still in the house. My God, my God. He's all over us, and he's keeping us whole.
Keep it up.
love you. Hey, keeping us alive. Hey, thank you, Lord.
You ain't tired of looking at us.
You and me, you see me.
Do you realize God is the one sustaining your life?
Yes.
For those who don't think so, when things are going wrong, when you're having problems, or when you're sick and down, who do you call on for help? When you don't know when to turn, and you make midnight calls to your pastor, to someone to pray for you, who are you calling on? Everything, he means something to you then.
Yeah.
When you can get something out of it, he means something to you.
There you go.
But when he needs to get something out of you, you got an excuse for not doing it.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Have we thought about that?
Mm-hmm.
Have we thought about when things are bad, things are not going the way we want to go, how we can call on him, how we can make promises of what we're going to do or we're not going to do? And he answers anyway, knowing that we're not going to keep our end of the bargain. What a great God we serve.
Awesome God.
How he knows that you're just trying to get out of something to get something. And he blesses you anyway.
Yes, he does.
He gives you joy. He gives you peace. He gives you happiness.
Teach.
He's there for you.
Yes, he is.
He don't let you down. He picks you up.
Yes, he does.
But we let him down. We find excuses to not just once day of the week on Sunday to come out and worship him and praise him and give thanks to what he's done in our lives, how he has brought us into a new way. Oh, what a mighty God we serve. Think of it. If God treat us the way we treat him, what will we be? How will we be? You know, if you want an example, just let somebody, just get mad at somebody and see how you treat them. How you don't want to talk to them, how you don't want to have nothing to do with them. But yet, we do things that against God, but he's still there. He still hears us when we call on him. He still gives us his all in all mighty joy and peace.
Yes, he does.
Oh, what a good God we serve. Before I go any further, I want to pray. Oh, Father God, we come to you, Father. We come willingly and want to learn more about you, do more, be more acceptable in your sight. Push us out of the way and let you come in, Father. As I preach and stand up in the way of the gate today, Father, give me what you would have me to say. Let me move and let you come in, Father. I pray that your Holy Spirit touch each and every one here today, Father, that they get a little more about you, willing to do a little more for you, willing to realize that you're the optimum one and you're the only one, Father. Touch this service, Father. Touch those that wanted to be here but couldn't be here. Touch those that are in other churches and need your word and need your encouragement, Father. We ask you these things and all things. In your son's name, Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen.
Amen.
If you stand for the reading of the word, come out of Romans 12, 1 through 3. We'll be in response to reading. If you don't have a Bible, it's in your response to reading. Therefore, I urge you, brethren and sisters, in view of God's mercy, to offer your body as a living sacrifice, holy and pleasing to God. This is your true and proper worship. Do not conform to the pattern of this world, but be transformed by the renewal of your mind. Then you will be able to test and approve what God's will is. He is good, pleasing, and perfect will. For the grace given me, I say to every one of you, do not think of yourself more highly than you are, but rather think of yourself with sober judgment in accordance with the faith God has distributed to each of you. If you will, I'd like to look at your neighbor and say, a true transformation. All right, now I'd like to take a few minutes to go around and shake hands and everything. Come back so we can get it going. All of those who can move around and shake hands. Jesus Christ. When you accept Jesus and he give you salvation, the angel sign your name in the book of life. The angel let you know that you're on your way. You're at the beginning of a new life. At the beginning of a new start. At the beginning of a lot of things. As long as you're down here, you're going to have problems, trouble, situations, circumstances probably beyond your control. But when the angels sign your name, they're giving you a pass. A pass to get to heaven. See, like I look at, they talk about here, if you go into some neighborhoods and they're the gangbangers or this or that, you have to wear certain colors or this or that, and then you represent another gang, they give you a pass to come in these neighborhoods. See, God gave you a pass to come to heaven through Jesus Christ. He gave you a pass where everybody can come together. You don't have to wear certain clothes. You don't have to do certain things but what he would have you to do with your pass. The angel in heaven to sign Get it back. Have you tried it? Have you seen it? But in the scripture today, we found out. It says, therefore, I urge you, brethren and sister, abuse God's mercy to offer your body as a living sacrifice, holy and pleasing to God. This is your true, proper worship. You notice the scripture said, to offer your body to God as a living sacrifice. God kind of begged you into his thing. He asked you to come in. He don't force you in, but he asked you to come in and accept his son as a living sacrifice, as a holy sacrifice, as things of what he would have you to do. See, when we holler about God's will and our will, when we sit down in prayer and say, Father God, let your will be done, we're telling him we want to do your will, not our will. See, but under our will, we do so much mischievous thing, so much wrongdoing, so much lying or cheating or drinking or smoking or doing things that not God's will. But we pray for God's will, but we still want to do our will. We still want to go to Burger King and have it our way. But if you're serving the Lord and you know God is in you, that you his temple, that he glorifies you, you need to start changing and start asking him what it is you want me to do instead of what I want to do. When we start asking God what it is you want me to do, then you hear the song say, the chains are falling. The chains of life will start falling. The circumstances and the bad and the different things that you go through will start falling. They won't bother you. God will give you peace and joy. And you change into a holy sacrifice. We're not of this world, but we're in this world. We're pilgrim sojourners. We're just here for a short time. If you live to be 200 years old, it's still a short time. To us, it's a long time. But you got to realize how long this world been in existence. Then you start realizing it's just a short time. Like the Flintstones say, just a little dab of duty. See? Just a little dab of God will do you, because he will give you more if you walk right, talk right, act right, and look right. If you start realizing it's not about me, but God, is you I serve. It's you that can transform me. It's you can make a difference in my life. Then it said in the second verse, do not conform to the pattern of this world. Be transformed by the renewing of your mind. Then you will be able to test and approve what God's will is, his good, pleasing, and perfect will. In other words, he's telling you, see, we're so busy trying to be like everybody else. We're so busy trying to do this, trying to please the world, that we put God on the outside of our life. We even like to people say, you don't have to go to church. Yeah, God is in me. God, we are the church. But yet, God's word said, as believers, we should come together. See, they don't know that one. As believers, it's in the word. As believers, we should come together, assemble together to worship and pray and exhort each other. And to learn the true word and the right way and the divided in the right word of the spirit of the truth. But people can, I don't need to go to church. The Bible, but they don't know. The Bible do tell you, as believers, we should come together. As believers, we should look out for each other. As believers, we should be exhorted. As believers, there's a man of God trying to help you learn the right way, learn the scripture, show you the scripture, teach you the scriptures. But people don't know that. They quit to say, I don't need church. I am the church. Because Jesus Christ said, on this rock, I'll build my church, and the gates of hell will not prevail. And we are to come together. See, there's two churches. You got the worldly church, and you got the local church. The worldly church is all the Christians around the world. The local church is the church that you go to in your neighborhood. A lot of people don't understand that. But God built it in an order that we need to know. We need to learn. We need to be a testimony. We need to be here, what he put us here to help bring in other people that need to make the change, need to have a transformation, need to do what God will is. But we can't change nobody when we're doing the same thing they're doing.
Preach.
If you're trying to get $1 million, how you gonna go get Joe off the street, ain't got nothing to help you get $1 million? You want to be around Oprah Winfrey or the Carters or Michael Jordan, somebody that know how to get something. And see, as a Christian, we should be the ones that know how to get something. Know how to get something through Jesus Christ. Know how to get something through God who's willing to give us. And quit being selfish about our own self. About, I don't do this, I don't do that. Read the scripture and see what God wants you to do. Ask him. How do you want me to walk? How do you want me to talk? Then in that third scripture it says, for by grace given to me, I say to every one of you, do not think of yourself more highly than you are, but rather think of yourself with sober judgment in accordance with the faith God has distributed to each one of us. See, what it's saying, sometimes we can get so high that we're better than anybody else. We can get so high that you can't tell me nothing. We can get so high about ourselves that don't touch me. We can get so high, even in the church, there's some people coming in, I don't want you sitting next to me. But do you realize a church is a practice ground for heaven? If God get you in heaven and say, well, you don't want to sit next to them, get out of here, go to hell. How would you feel? Think about what you do and say in church. You're getting ready for heaven. Instead of talking about, I don't feel like coming to church, that's when you should come. Well, instead of, I got a headache, that's when you should come. When I ain't got no money to put in church, that's when you should come. When I'm tired, and I just sit down and feel so bad, I don't feel like coming. But yet, you want somebody to pray for you. Oh, I pray for me if you come to church. See, when you leave, come in that door, you shouldn't feel the same way when you go out that door.
Right.
You should feel a whole lot better. If you put your problems down at the altar, the weight of the world is going to escape. The joy that God gave you is going to come in. The feeling that you have when you came in is gone. Because God can do it if you let him, if you believe in him, if you trust in him. God is good. Then we have some things to talk about, and then it will be long. Receive the mercy of God through Christ. You wanted mercy. You had to accept Jesus Christ. You wanted forgiveness. You had to accept Jesus Christ. You wanted blessing. You had to accept Jesus Christ. God loved each and every one of you. He did so by sending his son down here. In John 13, it said, God 16, he said, I so love the world that I gave my only begotten son. Whosoever believe in him shall not perish and have everlasting life. His son came from heaven to give you an opportunity to get to heaven. His son came from heaven with all the glory and all the things that was up there to come down here to transfer into human and a God to let you know that he's going through the same thing. He did the same trials and tribulation that he had to go through. You know, we talk about our car, but he had to walk. He didn't have to buy no gas, but he had to have some food. He was whooped, beaten, and drugged, and everything for your benefit. He said, by his stripes, he'll heal. What he took on for you. And how we say, no, I don't want no church. I'm tired. I've been up all night. I got things I'm doing. But that's when you need to come. You need to come to your problem, your situation. Bring it here. Put it on the altar. And let God handle it. Quit trying to stay at home and say, well, I ain't going to come to church till I get right. Well, if that's the case, you would have been in church if you had gotten right. You can't get yourself right. God will get you right. God will make the difference in the changes in your life. If you want to change. If you want to make it to heaven. If you want to deal with this world. You receive it through Jesus Christ. Offer your body a living sacrifice to God. God, here I am. See, it's just like cleaning up that bathroom. You know, my daughter come in here, she cleaned it up. She's a cleaning addict, or whatever you want to call it. Regardless of the cleaning addict, she's going to clean it. See, well, but other people make mess. Just like she cleaned that up behind other people, God cleans your mess up. And he goes behind you and straightens it up. He cleans it up. He changes it. Through Jesus Christ, is you can be, the Bible tells us, we can be washed white as snow. If we turn our problem, our situation, and quit finding circumstances that keep us from coming to church. But we want everybody to pray for us or pray for them, but we can't come in and ask the Lord, help me through what I'm going through. Let me see you. See, we take our mind off of God, like Peter when he was walking. And the wind was already up, but when he noticed the wind come up, he starts sinking. See, when problems come up, we start sinking. Then when we get too deep, then we're ready to, Lord, save me. Be like Lone Ranger. Come off at the pair and say, here I am, Lord. Help me now. I need you now. Help me. Show me what you want me to do. How you want me to do. Lord, I need you now. If you refuse to let the world push you into its mold, refuse to be like the people in the world. We ain't got what we dress like, talk like, act like, want to be like the people of the world, but yet we want to get to heaven. Then we wonder why we have so many problems, issues, and circumstances and things going on in our life, because we're caught up between heaven and hell. A lot of things we do that of the world. But there's something that we can do through Christ, through God, that is in the world, but is of his approval. People say you can't get drunk, but drinking, you can drink a little bit. God don't want you to get drunk. People say you can't gamble. You can't find it in the Bible. There are things that people say that you can't do, but God allows you to do, but you got to do just a little of it. God don't want you to do anything that you get so engrossed in it that you do it before you do it to him, that you ready to go and watch. He put the football, he put the basketball, but think about it. You rather watch TV, watch the basketball game, watch the football game, watch the baseball, watch the track, or watch something without saying, well, let me go spend this time with God. Even if he didn't bless you to have a TV that can you go back and rewind and come back and look at the game. He made it comfortable for you to put him first and then come back. But we want to see what we want to see until we need it. I said sometimes we put God in an old rocking chair. Hey, God, I don't need you right now. Go over there in that rocking chair and just rock it. Rock steady, baby.
Okay, now.
Until we need it. Then, oh, God, come on out of here. I need you. Where you been? Mm-hmm. Look what I done. Mm-hmm. That's when you admit that it wasn't him, but it was you. God didn't do it, but you. God haven't been angry or mad at you since Jesus died on the cross. Because Jesus took all your sin, all your bad desires and everything, and took them on for yourself. God not mad. People, our God, God is not mad. That's you. You ought to be mad at yourself for being a fool. But we need to be transformed. We need to learn about God. We need to know God didn't say we couldn't enjoy our life and do certain things. Man might tell you this or that, but there are things you can do. But God wants you to put him first and love him like he loves you. And he'll give you, he'll offer you, he'll give you a peace of mind, he'll give you a better direction, a way to go. Renew your mind daily with scripture. Other one, read the scriptures. Learn what the scriptures are telling you. Sunday school, Bible study, classes, and church, all of these things that help break down the scripture where you can understand, where you can enjoy what God wants you to enjoy, where you can have peace, where God wants you to have peace, where you can go through trials and tribulation without crying or frowning or looking at you. You know, when you can tell when somebody got a problem. Boy, their face change, they look sad, you know, and everything. But if you got God on your side, people don't know if you got problems or not. Because God will illuminate you. He'll light you through. He'll bring you through. He'll let you know it's going to be all right. He'll give you the joy, peace of mind that you need to bring you through. Well, your own word, well, you know he got it. And in his hand, give it to God. Learn to trust with him. Trust God for your transformation within you. Let him see, we try to change from the outside, but change it, and the spiritual change come from the inside out. We try to do things from the outside, but if we dig down and read and give to God, he transformed from the inside out. And when you come from the inside, from your heart, your mind, and the change to God, then people will see on the outside a better you. Another person, a way you can act and walk and talk. Then, six, commit to fulfilling his good and acceptable and perfect will to day to day. In other words, when you get up, you ask him, God, help me this day. Help me do your will. Help me walk the way you want to walk. I might have failed yesterday, but today is a new day. See, God said, I forgive you as much as you need to be forgiven to change. He tell you to forgive your brother seven times seven, or as often as he trespassed. Don't you know God will forgive you? But each day, you should be a little bit better. Each day, you shouldn't be like a record and recorded over and over. Each day, you should be showing a better improvement. Each day, you should be feeling better about yourself. Each day, you should be looking better. Each day, you should be talking better. Each day, you should be acting better. God will transform you. If you believe, if you want it, if you give him his time. God just asks him so many times just to spend a little time with him. Each day, you add on that time. And when you start adding on that time, it'd be just like an Arkansas. Pop, pop, feel. Oh, what a relief it is. How good it is to be in the glory of God. Then you start feeling like, I gotta go read my book. I ain't got time to look at the TV show. I ain't got time to answer no phone. I gotta be with the Lord for a few minutes so he can give me that joy. He can show me his will. God is good. He got an open plan for you. He'll make a difference. He'll transform you. He'll make you right if you believe him. And true transformation. In closing, have you been transformed? Have you been changed? See, we can think, oh, I done changed, I don't do this and do that. You know, when you really change, when people start saying, you don't act the way, you don't look the way, you don't talk the way, you don't do the same thing. There's a change in you. A change in you when you used to run the street, or when you used to fight, or when you drank, or used to do things that you don't do no more. And then you know what? They might look at it one way, but you look at it this way. I feel better. I'm healthy. I got peace of mind. I got joy. I don't worry about the things that I used to worry about. I don't have to pray about the things that I don't do no more. All I do is sit and talk with the Lord. I pray for others. I ask God to open up and show me his will. I ask the Lord to direct me and guide me. Have you been changed? Have you really been changed? Or you just, oh, I'm a Christian now. But you're still acting like the world. You're still doing the things of the world, but you're a Christian now. You got to be a living example. You got to ask the Lord, change me. Let me come in your will. Let me do the things that you would have me do. Let me be about your business, Father. I want the joy, the peace that you have promised to me and said you would give to me. And the things that you have helped me. I want to be transferred. I want a true transformation. The doors of the church are open. A true transformation. Three ways you can come to God: by letter, Christian experience, candidate for baptism. A true transformation. Have you been changed? Have you feel better about yourself? You don't be tired as you used to be. You don't be sick as you used to be. You don't be frowning and unhappy as you used to be. You don't even get in gossip like you used to. I said, anybody got quiet? I guess I'm changing. But God is good. God is in the blessing business. My God is in the overhaul business. And you get those through Jesus Christ. God will take that selfish eye out and put him in. God will show you the things you need to do to be on this journey, to be able to be glorified and help bring others in. Help people. When you change, a lot of people that want to change see your change, then they're going to change. You can bring a lot of people in the Lord by being transformed and doing it God's way, not your way in the other world. A change is coming. A change is coming. Church and they had a song, theme song, let's get right church and let's go home. She'd be sleeping till that song come up. She ready to get right and go home. But we gotta know, truly, this is a house of worship. This is a house of changing. This is a house when you down and out, instead of hollering about I'm too this, I'm too that, come to God. When you start sacrificing, bring your sacrifice, bring your time, and praise to him. And tell the people how good he is, how you feel in the church. When you can come to church, not be put down or talked about, but be delivered and have a peace of mind and see him in another way. God is working. It's good. He transformed. He transformed. We'd be too sick to stay at home. The only way you're too sick to stay at home, you got something contagious or you can't walk. But other than that, you need to be in church. If you can get out and do it and ain't get contagious or anything, because you can't stay at home and make no money, but you can come to the Lord, pray, and ask him to help you. You can't stay at home and get no food, but you can come to the Lord and ask him to help bless you. The thing that you can come and do that God will bless you in to do. Sooner than later, I'll pray when we get out of here.
You say you want me to pray?
No, I said sooner than walk in, I'll pray when we get out.
Okay.
Okay. You here for a hearing aid. Not a stopping aid. Oh, Father God, we come this day. We give thanks to you, Father. We're thanking you for what you've done and what you're doing in our lives, Father. We thank you for what we have heard today. We thank you for all churches, not just this church. All leaders, not just this leader, but all leaders in your word, Father. We ask a blessing for all the way around the world that the worshiping and praising you and singing you and giving you credit to all things, Father. I would pray that something was said or done today that make us better Christians, make us better people. Let us be able to care and reach out to each other, Father. Help us be what you would have us be, Father. As we leave here at Travel Mercy's home, job, or wherever we go, Father, let us be able to tell somebody something good about you. Let us feel the joy and the happiness and the knowledge and the understanding that you would give us, Father. We just say thank you, Lord. Thank you for what your son is doing and just doing. We ask you these things and all things. In the son's name, Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen.
Amen. Amen.